is the first guy that you'll see. He has a stressful job, only 21, has stopped 202 of 220 Penguin shots. His team isn't here tonight without him, especially his effort late in Game 4, his Game 7 first time. Matt Murray's first Game 7 as well. 22 years old, plus one day. Birthday yesterday, has stopped 116 of 129 Lightning shots. His team isn't here tonight without him. Sidney Crosby got the winning goal in Game 2, in Game 3, in Game 6. Three winning goals in a series. This is his fifth Game 7. Last time here, Steven Stamkos was a scratch. He only took the morning skate. That's all he's been doing for the longest time. Tonight, the captain of the Lightning plays. Crosby's line starts, and we are underway with Game 7. Hedman to Stroman, and back in, and an icing. 9 seconds in, an offensive zone faceoff coming up for the Penguins.
Well, Doc, you touched on Andrei Vasilevsky, and the big reason why we are even in a Game 7. He has been the best goaltender in this series without question. So on the other hand, the Pittsburgh Penguins, in my opinion, have been the better team, but the great equalizer, the guy in goal for the Tampa Bay Lightning, 3-3. Somebody looking to go to take on the San Jose Sharks in the Stanley Cup Final.
And he has to block that one right off the faceoff. Hedman ahead, off of Callahan, and back down, and stopped and carefully covered by Matt Murray.
Eddie and Doc, he's been outshot every single game he's played. Just to back up your point one step further on Vasilevsky, the Penguins through the first six games have dominated the shot clock, and there have been major quality chances against that man, and he's hung tough.
Tyler Johnson will be in to take the faceoff. There's some wound licking being done by the star players for the Lightning after the last game. Kucherov, Johnson, and Victor Hedman. All out there right now. We're minus 11 in the last game. Johnson able to take this and angle it back off. Too far for Kucherov. Ben Lovejoy fired it around, and it swirls on back and racing back. But not able to deny the icing was Carl Hagelin.
Oh, not a bad play there by the Pittsburgh Penguins. I know they iced the puck, but given the Tampa Bay Lightning a little bit of a opportunity to get in behind the defense, try to stretch out the area in between the forwards of the Lightning and the defense, and just puts a little bit of a seed of doubt back there to let them know that they might try to move that puck in behind to get an odd man break.
Thrown high by Lovejoy, taken on by Schuster, flipped along but followed up by Bonino, and the shot was blocked away by Johnson. Again a shot and a save made by Vasilevsky there. The toss by Mata, the throw by Hagelin, and back in it goes, and a fire wagon change by the Penguins. Malkin comes out.
First shift for Stamkos on the ice right now.
The pass comes over for Callahan, one in Stamkos, it's played off his leg. Now Garrison with it there. The malady was blood clots, had surgery for it on April the 4th. Yeah, there's a certain amount of risk, but less now that he's been cleared, of course. Rattled on around, and Kunitz tipped it. Coburn up with it there, flipped one off a leg. Spun back across. Dumoulin got help to clear it back out, and down to play. This is Coburn. Coburn tried to fire the puck into the empty net at the end of the warm-up, and Evgeny Malkin stopped him. Malkin going to work on this play, and took it away from Kukku. Then thrown back along, and ahead to the carry by Kunitz. Kunitz able to rag it back along, got it back for a drive, and that one turned aside. The rocket that came from Ian Cole in search of his first Stanley Cup playoff goal.
Nice exit out of the zone there by the Penguins.
Floated back as far as center, chopped at by JT Brown. The follow-up, though, comes from Bonino. Got it on across to Hornquist, turned along by Crosby. Crosby worked on there by JT Brown, reaching in was Namestnikov, and a crowd gathers right near the Tampa Bay Lightning bench. Protecting himself is the backup goaltender. Interesting to watch. Meanwhile, this comes back along. Those sticks can come up there, and he doesn't have his mask on. Why should he? To the back now. It's thrown back along by Ranta. Settled down by Crosby. Wedged away from him by Hedman. Hornquist back, and a drive that went wide from Ben Lovejoy. Sent back along by Mata. Off the stick of Hedman. Pitching in is Lovejoy. Long jam there. Hornquist trying to center. Hedman took it there. Nudged on to Namestnikov. Dropping back is Mata. picks up Hedman, and the shot steered wide by Mata, and he corrals it behind.
Well, Nemestikov had Victor Hedman, who jumped into the play. He started it all. He had him over to his right. He never looked over. Might have had a breakaway from the blue line in.
Schuster spins it away, losing his stick, Eric Fair, but now it's played back to Schuster by Garrison. Schuster ahead, and that one trickled back in. Back to get it is Letang, wedged off there by Brian Boyle, the big man, and this is chopped back out. A lot of big men. You could put together a starting five on most college basketball teams with the height of some of the Tampa Bay Lightning, including the goaltender. They can't even dress tonight. Ben Bishop injured in game one. Ben's only 6'7". Played along now by Letang. Tangled up a bit and kicked on back to Garrison. Wanted to flip further, but Kessel stashed it across. Kucherov brings it back. Kucherov delaying now. Shooting one, and that blocked down by Letang. Lifted up to Kucherov. Keeps the pressure on. Spins it on back for a shot by Cuckoo. And that blocked away by the netminder Matt Murray. Jammed along as Kessel tried to play. Thrown by Johnson and fired wide by Kucherov. Brushed along by Haglin and then lifted back up high. The bouncer comes back for Alex Killorn. Then Coburn and then Cuckoo. Slater Cuckoo holds behind his own net with 4:10 played in the first period. And the shots on goal show nothing, nothing. A lot of action, no shot. Around this one goes Amata there, but Callahan tried to play it behind, dragged along by Callahan again. He's got Stamkos in front, but he couldn't take the pass. Hedman threw one, but it was well wide and cannot be played until Stroman gets back to his own end. Stroman with a nice head fake, able to get back ahead. His pass came back across for Palat. A kneeling block there by Justin Schultz. Played on by Sheary. Worked on by Malkin, but he could not get by Stroman, and the puck goes back for J.T. Brown. Hedman marches ahead there, able to flip one off the glove of Paquette, fielded by Hornquist, steps right back in. Hornquist with a shot that snapped out of the air and held by Vasilevsky.
Talked about how aggressive the Tampa Bay defense are, especially when pucks are along the wall. Look at the pressure here from Braden Coburn, and then he gets great support from Tyler Johnson. Pinch in by the D, and then the quick chance just misses the short side. And talk about the active defense. There's a pass from Hedman. Left part of your screen. There he goes to the net. Good stick from Ole Mata on the Nemestikov. A good opportunity there. A couple of good opportunities by defensemen being very active through the middle of the ice and in the offensive zone.
Filppula prevailed on the faceoff, but it's lost to Crosby, then taken back by Valtteri Filppula and around behind. Filppula playing in his ninth, game number 7. Owns a Stanley Cup from the Detroit Red Wings. Don't miss a moment of the Stanley Cup playoffs with NBC Sports Live Extra, streaming every game free with your TV subscription. That includes NBCSN, available online, on the go, and on connected TVs. For details, visit NBCSports.com/Live Extra. Bonino, Filppula, won by Bonino, and Dumoulin knocked down in front, picked up by Schuster. And Palat twisted it back out. Might be a break here, brought back in by Drouin and steered wide by Letang. Filppula up with it there, got it along to Drouin, tried to center, but two Penguins on him. Brought up by Phil Kessel, led on the wing to Haglin, shot, and that held by Vasilevsky.
Little things matter, face-offs in particular, off an icing. Valtteri Filppula loses that draw clean to Nick Bonino, shot on goal, and if you're Jason Garrison, just clear the crease, take a body and get it away. Dumoulin with the quick release, but watch Jason Garrison making sure Carl Haglin can't get to that rebound. It's a real good job. And then later on, you see Haglin come down, whip it on goal. As Eddie likes to say, a shot's never a bad thing. Haglin just puts it on goal, and Vasilevsky devours it.
Crosby on the faceoff win. Got it back for Mata, and the shot winds up being nothing. And so a new puck. Every draw so important, especially the offensive zone ones. And the hardest thing is to have a good faceoff percentage if you're in the defensive zone a lot. Tyler Johnson is here. His stick has to be down first. swept along by Sherry, brought back up by Kucherov, and back out to Alex Killorn. Rolled back in, Dumoulin goes together. Killorn on him, help came from Letang. More work though, knife back to Johnson, around behind to Kucherov, run into by Dumoulin. Dump back off now for Hornquist, tried to work it further, but it's turned back over to Killorn, floated back up to Kucherov again. Matched there by Dumoulin, Kucherov handed it back, and it was lost back out by Coburn, and then popped up high, and out of play, no penalty coming from that. 13:39 to go, first period. The shots are 2-0, Pittsburgh. You're watching the NHL Stanley Cup Playoffs presented by Guy.
Three forwards below the goal line. Alex Killorn recognizes that Johnson comes in, but that's what John Cooper wants. When they have an opportunity, it's not a two-man forecheck. When the opportunity presents itself, they don't mind having three guys below the goal line. And the offensive push.
Right, and part of that, I think, is not having Trevor Daley for Pittsburgh. Sure. That hurts their puck handling a lot.
Very good point.
Slater, Kukrow ahead for the Tampa Bay defense. Brushed back in by Callahan. And around it is Murray. Rolls one up high. That's booted on back. Malkin tried to step by. Could not. Thrown around in front of net with a quick active stick that came from Dumoulin.
Penalty on Malkin from behind. He hit Palat after he tried to pass that puck, I believe, to Steven Stamkos.
Going to be an interference call. Sure enough, Malkin is the guy who will go to the penalty box.
Andre Palat got this puck, and instead of shooting it, he tries to make a pass. Good steal there, and then right there is the interference. Right call made. The trailing official made that call. Tampa Bay never got a shot on goal. And Palat looking for Stamkos, who was all by himself right in front of Matt Murray.
Was he ever, Eddie Boyle? Oh boy, it was wide open. Dumoulin with a heroic play with a stick.
Malkin had the first penalty in game number 6 as well in the game. 5 straight kills for the Penguins penalty killing unit. And off this faceoff, it's sent on back to Hedman. Kucherov turning with it there. Blocked across. Brian Boyle will be the screen in front of the net as this hops off the shelf and out of play. No penalty resulting.
Yeah, this is what Eddie and Doc were talking about. You see number 91 in white in behind the defense, and he sees a turnover. Watch Brian Dumoulin with that active stick, like a serpent's tongue, coming right out to bat that puck right there.
Malkin's the guy that turned the puck over because of the good stick by Strawman, and then he's the one that takes the penalty.
Stamkos 36 goals in the regular season to lead the team. Hedman able to get this one across. It's poked on now to Kucherov. Weaves it across now in the toss to Drouin. Threw it in front. Whacked at there by both Lovejoy and Boyle. One aside. And it is cleared all the way down.
Looks like Brian Boyle's going to go to the penalty box.
He is.
Right behind the net as the puck went in behind Matt Murray to the left.
Ball is a slash.
And there's a slash that he's talking about. Kelly Sutherland, number 11, saw number 11 with the infraction, and he goes to the box.
Boy, Ben Lovejoy, who has played outstanding in this round against the Tampa Bay Lightning, he lifts up the stick of Brian Boyle, takes the puck away, one whack to Lovejoy, and then there the whack on Nick Bonino. It was the one that the official saw, so 4-on-4 hockey.
How about Ben Lovejoy in game number 6? Played almost 23 minutes. That's the most he's played all playoff for the Pittsburgh Penguins.
They don't have many unrestricted free agents in the offseason, but Ben is one of them. Brought back ahead now by Phil Pellett. Dropped on back. Hedman. 4-4. Game 7. And the Lightning are shotless. The Penguins have had only 2, and the probing continues with 7 3/4 minutes gone in the first. Killorn lobbed it off. Taken by Philpola. Drawn for Killorn. Blocked off by Murray. Popped wide of the cage. Now Dumoulin shook it around behind. Chris Letang brings it ahead. Threw one that went away from Kunitz. Rattled on around for Hedman. The two guys out there that play the most for their teams, along with this now, is Johnson. Johnson breezes around behind with it, sends it on to the back. Garrison, a shot that went wide. Rebound backhander save. Rebound popped wide. Center round now for Johnson again. Slugged it behind to Kucherov. The two dangerous guys out there up front for the Lightning. Kucherov able to field one back now for Garrison. Then along to Kucherov. Intercepted by Kunitz. Tucked across to Bonino. And he pivots back.
Good stick by Mata there. The force to turn over with Kucherov.
Schultz able to take his own pass. In 5 seconds, the power play will begin. It will last half a minute. And that time is now. Malkin is out of the box. Power play 1-for-6 for the Penguins in this series here in Pittsburgh. Malkin able to shake it on back. Dumoulin with it there. Handed it across Letang. And then over to Crosby. Crosby to Letang. Has Dumoulin. Fakes. Gives to Malkin. He wanted to shoot. Did not. Malkin back to Letang. Dumped the shot. Broke the stick. It's Philpola bringing it ahead. 3 seconds to go on the power play. Puck swung back in by Hedman. And that'll take care of it. Both teams penalized, no damage to either. Matt Murray made 3 stops. The only 3 he's had to make in the period. Brought back up by Lovejoy, handed on now, and turning right in, it's McCullen! Save made by Vasilevsky.
You don't see Anton Strahlman get hung out to dry very often. This is a tremendous pass and reception by Matt Cullen. Off his skate to his stick coming in right around Anton Strahlman. Look at that reception of a pass by Matt Cullen coming in all alone. And Vasilevsky answers it.
Yeah, the one thing you don't want to be doing is standing still in the middle of the ice. And Doc, you talked about the chances for the Lightning on that 4-on-4. Here's Valtteri Filppula over to Alex Killorn. And get a lot on that, but certainly going hard to the blue paint with Anton Strahlman. You don't want to get caught standing still in the middle of the ice. He was caught in between, and KG veteran like Cullen recognizing that and getting a good chance.
Stamkos chased out of the faceoff, so it's Drouin against Matt Cullen. Cullen wins. Lovejoy holds. And back in, Kunoffel. Wedged off, though, couldn't make a play. Shuffled on by Garrison. Good challenge from Ian Cole. And that one is sent back along. And now Cullen swept it away and back down. And no icing on this play, so Vasilevsky out to handle. Slung it back around, and it can be directed out by Palat. Quickly turned by Cullen and back through. Shift change on for the Penguins. Past the halfway mark of the first. Here's Palat bringing it on. Palat sent one across. It careened over to Kunitz. He dragged it free and was able to tap one on. Schultz couldn't wheel it out, but it bounced on ahead for Rust. Rust able to play it back in, but back on to get it is J.T. Brown. But into the path of Malkin. Malkin fed it back. Mata faked the drive across. Drive by Letang is saved. Then scooped up by Namestnikov. Moving back in is Mata. Good challenge there on Cuckoo. Back down deep it comes. They try the other side this time, and it's Paquette with a pass. Cuckoo with the take, and he steps back in. Dropped it to Namestnikov. Checked from behind by Malkin, and the puck swung wide.
Heck of an effort there by Malkin to come all the way back and deny that possible chance.
How about the live legs of Slater Cuckoo here tonight in Game 7? He's jumping all over the gym.
Rust with a little trouble with the checking of the linesman, so this one is floated back out again by Lovejoy. They have to be somewhere, and sometimes they are in the way.
No regret it. No out of bounds in this game.
That one glanced off the referee. Meanwhile, this is Crosby moving along, checking his man so that Hornquist can play it on back to Dumoulin. Connects back on now, and Sheary brings it in. Shook one across, hoping for Crosby. Got Dumoulin, and Dumoulin slams on the brakes to shake Johnson. Dumoulin backhands one, knocked down by Hornquist. Then a backhander by Crosby, and it's directed away. Good opportunity for the Penguins there, and now it's Alex Killorn able to bring it ahead. Handed on to Hedman, and Hedman steps back in. That's right in the path of Ben Lovejoy, and Lovejoy can connect circle to circle across now to Dumoulin. Strahlman dumped it back out. It squibbed on over for Drouin. Worked the wing to Filppula. Filppula shot. A save made by Matt Murray. And he hangs on. 7:53 to go, first period. Crosby with a close-in chance. He's had the same luck as everybody else. None.
Stamkos, on their lineup, how much do you have to adjust as a coach?
not much. You know, we're concerned about our team. We're just going to try to play our game. Obviously, he's a very good player. We've got to be aware when he's on the ice, but we're more concerned about what we do.
What's the most important quality of your game that can make the difference here in Game 7?
I just think we got to continue to try to play behind their D. When we play behind their D, we force them to go back and get pucks. We establish that relentless puck pursuit game. We're at our best.
Thanks a lot, Mike.
Okay, Pierre.
Just trying to get that puck in behind. A couple of replays we've shown. Wherever it is on the ice, just force the Tampa Bay Lightning defense to respect the speed and force them to turn around and chase pucks down.
Matt Cullen, defensive zone win. This one is booted on back. Callahan had it knifed away, though. Good reach from Mata. It pops out of play into the bench area. And so, again, play is stopped.
He didn't get to go on the power play. Doc was talking about his 36 goals for Steven Stamkos. 14 of those goals were on the power play. That made him number three in the league in the power play in the regular season. And that's where I think he can make a difference if they get power play opportunities, him on the power play, Doc.
Last time he had a goal was 5 days ahead of his final game before now. And that was against the Florida Panthers, so it counts as two. Bounced ahead there, and it sailed on back. And Stamkos is after it. Then along to Palat. Palat sent it onto the back, and so it is handed across to Hedman. That one went wide. Palat tried to get there off the back of the cage. Callahan, then Palat, and then Stamkos, but blocked. And punched back out again, and ahead with it is Cullen, and he's able to step back in. Cullen's pass was off Hedman, tangled in his skates. Then he's run into by Kunal. Crosby retrieves this one. Shot it wide, and Vasilevsky out to get it with under 7 minutes to go. Handed away by Vasilevsky, kept it alive, did the Penguins, and then it's floated right back along for a little jab by Johnson that goes to center. Dropping back defensively was Sheary to hand over to Dumoulin, and ahead but through Crosby. Crosby able to drag it back along, though. Onside play. Crosby holds, but it's knifed away by Johnson. Good defense by him. Sheary tries to keep going. Johnson in the way. Hedman put it into the pile. It came back to him. Tried it again. And this one is spun loose off of Killorn. Flexes it back out. And Hornquist has it in his sights. Drop back onto Crosby. Couldn't shake it by Hedman. Attack met by resistance. The story of the first period so far. Shots on goal are 5-4 Penguins. Brushed right back across and can be taken on and thrown across by Kunitz. But read by Drouin. Drouin able to just pitchfork it back to the corner. Off the shelf it plopped. Schultz able to reverse it onto Letang. Kunitz there, collides with his man, and that's Schuster. The battle continues now as reaching in is Boyle. Squirts loose to the corner, and it's Schultz. But then Boyle, then Schultz. Kunitz plopped it back out again, and the pressure off for now so that the defense can make a change. Letang and Schultz come off for the Penguins. On Armada and Cole. Mata retrieves this one, jammed it up the boards, but it's taken at center by Schuster, and then Boyle wanted to make a play but could not. Lofted ahead now for the take by Malkin. He decides to throw it on back, and it's Mata there. Then Cole. Off of Kessel and back in and charging after it, Hagelin. Thrown away from him by Vasilevsky. Getting it was Kessel and pitching it behind. Hagelin got there. Hagelin continues to battle. Squirted away from Kessel. Can be taken on and sent by Kuku. Rolled on out to center and swatted on back by Lovejoy and back in. Under 5 minutes to play first period, and the accelerated probing in this game continues. A down and outer, and it goes all the way down. Not out, but will be brought back on an icing. This August, the world will come together in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, as athletes from across the globe compete for country and Olympic gold. The 2016 Olympic Games coming August 5th to the networks of NBC Universal.
Tampa Bay's had a couple of big hits in the offensive zone on defensemen, and Ben Lovejoy was one of those recipients on that last shift, and this ends up being a long shift. A lot here. I'm sorry, Doc.
That's all right. Letang's shot was blocked by Callahan and is rolled on back.
And he's a little nicked up off that shot block. It was an awkward attempt.
Here's Crosby gaining the zone and drifting and backhanding one that floated wide. Hornquist after that along with Drouin, kept by Letang and sent right on goal. An accurate backhander by him. pushed back along, and Filppula has to drop back to take and then give it on to Schuster. Garrison off of Boyle. Two Boston College guys collide. This is directed back in and carried by Malkin. Drifts, shoots, and directed up high by Vasilevsky and out of play. What do you think so far? Pretty good, isn't it? 4:05 to go. First period playing game seven at home. The Penguins have lost the last four straight. Vasilevsky, a strong save made on Phil Kessel off that faceoff.
Boy, they're winning a lot of offensive zone faceoffs, Pittsburgh.
Trickled back to Hedman. The scoring chances are 3-2 in favor of the Penguins, even before that one. Johnson gets over to Kalorn, dropped back in, and it's Letang. Shoulders there with Johnson, kept along by Kalorn. Ripped off by Dumoulin, knifed down by Letang, popped on near Kessel. Right back it comes to Letang again and reversed it behind to Dumoulin. Dumoulin sent down while falling, played it ahead to Kessel, and Kessel challenged by Johnson. Still it's not out. Johnson rolled it back in. This is the kind of containment that normally Pittsburgh is able to do on Tampa Bay. And it's taken away by Kucherov, given back for Pilat, and a save and a juggle and a hold by Matt Murray.
The strength of Kucherov's very apparent here against Christopher Letang. Doc talked about hemming him in. Look at the strength of 86 in white against Letang. Outmuscles him at the point of attack. Gives it up to Pilat. Pilat whips it on goal.
Take a look at that face-off play. Phil Kessel right-handed. So advantageous to have a right-handed shooter on the left side of the ice. The good face-off win that Pierre touched on earlier. Bonino to Kessel. When you see a winger on his off wing like that, it's advantageous to get to the middle of the ice on the strength of his forehand, and it's a good chance off a clean face-off win.
This one is won by the Lightning and Filppula. Schuster across to Garrison. Garrison with a shot that went wide. Bounced on to Schuster. Schuster shouldered there by Kunockel. Floated along by Lovejoy, and right out it comes for the carry by Matt Cullen. Cullen rolled off there by the hit that came from Drouin. Forced around to Pilat. Challenge, though, came from Lovejoy, and they hold it up. And further, popped on now for Garrison to give across to Schuster. University of Nebraska Omaha guy gave it on to Garrison and right back again. Schuster, another one of those tall guys at 6'7". Brought right back ahead now to Kunitz. Kunitz got it to Malkin. And Malkin sent one just wide as he was trying to connect either on goal or with Russ.
That all started because of the bad pass by Schuster up to Pilat on the boards. Had nobody in between him and Pilat and put it right in his skates. The next thing you know, the Penguins are coming on the 3-on-2.
Doyle, Tampa Bay coaches know it too. Rick Bonus very demonstrative behind Andre Schuster, whispering in his ear right now.
It is Cuckoo taking this one and swinging it along off Callahan's stick and back. 2 minutes to go in the period. Sidney Crosby, the Penguins captain, floated that one back out. Chopped along by Hornquist, but nicely wanded away in a good reach by Coburn. Now Cuckoo again. Crosby and Hornquist and Connor Sheary are out for the Penguins. A change now brings out Dumoulin and Letang defensively. Moving back in is Kucherov. Domestikov with a bit of a shove there for the Lightning. Along it comes to Kucherov. He's got Johnson nearby. Then Coburn, but stepping in the way and floating it back out was Crosby. And a tangle there. And the fans wanted a penalty and didn't get it. This one tripled along and getting it is Hornquist. Hornquist got it on now to Sheary. Sheary trying to shake his way loose. Still has nice possession of it. And Sheary, a shot that's knocked down. Hedman able to bring it right back. Johnson able to motor ahead. Popped it on the wing for Kucherov. Turns there. Fed one across. Hedman, side of the net, put it through the legs of Johnson. Now across to Hedman again. Fires a sliding block by Hornquist. Popped right back to the corner. Letang able to shuttle it behind. Taken there by Bonino. Bonino lofted it on, and then Dumoulin is able to pop one that goes on back and down for the stop by Vasilevsky.
Great play by Kucherov to get the puck to Hedman, and he just slapped it a little bit too hard to Tyler Johnson, who was all by himself to the left of Matt Murray.
No icing on this play, so it is Murray out to handle. Forced it on along, and it bounced onto Haglund. Plays it ahead now for Bonino, and then up the wing to Kessel. Kessel, a shot, shoulder high, And Vasilevsky looking as everyone looks for that one. Popped along off the outside of the cage by Kessel. Still they battle for it behind. Kessel trying to jam it loose. It's Garrison there. Angling one that goes back down. No icing on this play either in the last dozen seconds of period one. It is Malkin with seven. Malkin with three. Haglin to the back. Drive. Stopped. Liam, Mike, and Keith are coming up on the Lexus Intermission Report. The guys will analyze Stamkos' return and the unique... Your thoughts on that man and the first?
I think a good start for Steven Stamkos, having not played in almost 8 weeks. Taking four faceoffs, only won one. I'm sure for John Cooper, he wants to make sure he's protecting him, especially when those faceoffs are in his own zone.
Eddie and Doc, he's the only guy in this game that didn't have a bruise coming in.
Along to get, this is Lovejaw. Lifted along further, Sheary. But in the way, Strawman. Palat fell down, but it came to Filppula, then back to Hedman. Couldn't play it through because of Hornquist. Penguins flood in, but they have to double back while falling. Mata got it to Hornquist, glove down, and played to the corner by Victor Hedman. The defense play it, and then the forwards. No icing on this, it's chased down by Hedman. And in the period of the long change, the Penguins make their first one. Hedman flipped it back in. Comes to the bench for a change of his own. Dumoulin with it there. Pass directed back down. It's Garrison to retrieve and touch it over to Schuster. Schuster flipped it away from a glove and back down and a race on. And so it has to be played by Murray because of Kalorn's hustle. Shifted on back and it popped out of play off one of the lightning, I should say, and they want the faceoff back to center. John Hancock takes you inside the glass. Here's Pierre.
Thanks, Doc. If you're the Tampa Bay Lightning, one adjustment you want to make, defensive zone faceoffs. Pittsburgh cleaned them out in the first period and created a plethora of scoring chances because of their really smart, wise faceoff plays in the offensive zone. Courageous shot block by Callahan, but there's a play Eddie illustrated. Look at Phil Kessel coming in on the off wing. Quality chance. Tampa's got to bear down in defensive zone faceoffs.
This is Letang off of Bonino and back in. Schuster back to get it. The battle on and tumbling along was Haglin. Trying to recover that time was Kessel while he went down. It came on back now for Kucherov. Garrison started it on. Johnson with a pass that went flying by Kalorn. Hustling down to play this and drawing an icing because of his hustle that time was Lovejoy.
I had a chance to talk to Ben Lovejoy this morning after the pregame skate and just talking about his play and how important communication is with his defensive partner, Ole Mata. He's played a terrific series here against the Tampa Bay Lightning. And as you mentioned, Doc, a little bit earlier, a guy that doesn't have a contract going into next year.
Here's Kunitz rifling it on back, and Lovejoy a shot, and that went wide. Sent back along and chopped back out again by Kalorn, striding back to get this as Mata. Mata, the long toss. The take by Malkin. Gains the zone, drives into Kunitz. On now for Rusty.
Numbers going the wrong way for Tampa and the right way for Pittsburgh. It all started with a lost faceoff. You see Callahan going for the big hit. He's waiting for Rutz. There's no resistance. And he just snaps it high. Look at the Tampa Bay Lightning going for a change. That's Andre Schuster, but the quick up by Ole Mata. Malkin drops it off to Kunitz. You see the late change, wide open ice, and Brian Rust, who was a hero in Game 6, Eddie, got the icebreaker here in Game 7.
Penguins have struck first. Brought back ahead by Sheary, laid on to Crosby. Crosby a shot and a rifle shot directed up and out of play. Kunitz and Malkin the assist. And 1:55 of the second.
Well, what Pierre was talking about, look at this area of the ice. And for the Pittsburgh Penguins, it's pretty simple. Move the puck up quickly. Malkin to Kunitz. Here comes Ross right up the center of the gut. And that quick little change of pulling the puck into his body and then shooting back the other way over the glove of Vasilevsky. Threw that angle off just enough. And Rust goes top shelf.
Weak toss along by Paquette, fielded by Malkin, handed on to Rust. Stash back in again. Vasilevsky waits for Hedman to play. Carried back up by Boyle. Boyle challenged, passed it back over. Paquette played it around the roulette wheel, and it can be handled there by Strawman. Jostled by Kunitz, taken off by Malkin, and popped back out. Hedman takes over there and hands on to Paquette. And he gains the zone and shoots one that's directed to the corner. Now Boyle turns one along that's directed up off the glass and out of play.
Cole and Paquette. Little bit of a shot by Cole to initiate everything, and then Paquette retaliated. And let's see what referee Wes McCauley decides to call. Looked like both guys. It looked like Cole gave him a little, either a forearm shiver or an elbow, and then Paquette started wailing on Cole from behind.
Kelly Sullivan, Wes McCauley talking it out right now.
Watch below the goal line. There's Cole. And then there's the elbow. That's exactly what Paquette took exception to. I don't know if the official initially saw. I don't think there was an initial penalty on Cole. But certainly the right call made. And I think Ian Cole's pretty lucky that he wasn't the only one that got sent off to the penalty box. Once Paquette retaliated, it was a pretty easy call.
I think, Eddie, I think it's a power play for Tampa. Based on what Kelly Sullivan's saying, I think he did see. He's coming over right now.
Well,
four on four, he's telling both benches now. Doc and Eddie.
Okay. A man apiece for 2 minutes. Kelly Sutherland, Wes McCauley are the referees here in the game tonight. You get a seventh game assignment on merit. And normally that means you're moving on to the next round because you've been judged by the league as being the best. And they are the guys in charge of this one with Johnny Murray and Derek Amell as the linesman. Cole elbowing and Paquette roughing. Those penalties force both teams to be a man short. So four against four, Bonino brings it up with Hagelin and Letang and Dumoulin. Those are the four Penguins. Stepping by is Garrison, out there with Johnson, Kucherov, and Schuster. Vasilevsky at one end of the ice, at the other is Murray. Garrison further, but taken by Hagelin. Ex-captain at Michigan, popped one to the corner. Schuster tries to play it there, and does. Got it on to Johnson, and ahead to Kucherov. The leading Eastern Conference goal scorer, 86 in white, tests Matt Murray. Little trouble there, but he got it on to Letang, to Dumoulin, and ahead now to Hagelin. Hagelin able to trickle it back in and come to the bench for a change.
Looked like Hagelin wanted to regroup there, get the puck back to his defense, not give up possession of it, but Hedman did a good job of shutting him off.
Crosby and Kessel out there for the Penguins. A pass comes across. Olimata, who is out there with Lovejoy, rolls one ahead. Kessel trying to get to that one, but cannot. It's Drouin rolling it behind, and Crosby, a rocket of a shot that kicked on back and off Ben Lovejoy, handcuffing him, so he drops back to center. Drouin and Palat, as well as Hedman and Strawman for the Lightning. So the last 38 of the coincidental minors. Tucked over by Kessel to Crosby. Rolls one ahead for Kessel. Save made by Vasilevsky. Pops around, hoping to get it with Crosby, and it's thrown on that by Kessel. Crosby around for the backhand. Oh, and a scramble there, and around behind it's Kessel again, or rather Crosby again. To the back now to Dumoulin. Turns it on for Crosby, but it's Kessel. Then to the back now it's Letang. Letang drifts and hands it back. Dumoulin on a cross. Kessel connects with Dumoulin, driving the net. What a cross. He couldn't get the pass there. And it's Palat. Sidestepping one, sidestepping two. Malkin took it away, fresh from the bench. Right out of the box. It is Cole to drum it back in. And we're back in full strength, and it's Malkin. Malkin gave it across. Here's Cole. Had trouble settling it down. Fires one that went wide. Curled right over to Malkin. Malkin draws several of the Lightning to him and then tries to pull three. Got it to the boards. Mata moved there. Hedman guided it away. Malkin must play at center. Sort of frantic, isn't he? Chances are 9-3 in the game in favor of the Penguins. Kessel 3, Crosby 3. On with it now is Philpott. And got it on for a shot that is stopped and covered off the stick of Killorn by Murray.
Well, 4-on-4 hockey produces a couple of great chances for Sidney Crosby. What a pass here to Phil Kessel. Area pass, great save from Vasilevsky. The puck ends up finding Sidney Crosby here. Look at the patience. Wait. What a save with the left pad from Vasilevsky.
And that's really the strength of Crosby. Poise under fire, and the backhand, which is usually lethal, just couldn't elevate it. And then watch this one for Killorn off the 3-on-3. Matt Murray, no rebound left for Ryan Callahan.
But just the patience of Sidney Crosby, and he's going to school. You see the look on his face there on the Jumbotron here at Council. Looking to see maybe what he could have done, but just, I mean, the patience there to hold on to that puck, not shoot it. And then Vasilevsky, remember that stop. Incredible athleticism by the Lightning goaltender.
Off the tie-up, it comes on back to Schultz. Wisconsin product sails it ahead. Kunoffel trying to get by, still trying to reach. Tangled up with Coburn, they shoulder in the corner. Cuckoo back along, Stamkos with a pass that was off of Boyle. Then Cole, then along now for Fair, then Schultz, then ahead for Cullen, but offside is called. Formula One is on NBC. We head to the French Riviera for one of the crown jewels of motor racing, the Monaco Grand Prix. That's Sunday morning, 7:30 Eastern on NBC. Live at the speed of F1. Ryan Rust at training camp on the first scrimmage shift was playing with Sidney Crosby. Seemed to bode well for the year, though it wasn't apparent right away. Now it's swept across for Coburn. Slowed down by Sheary, pitched on by Kucherov, handled by Dumoulin. Carried back in by Cuckoo, trying to get by Letang, no luck. Scaled back along by Hornquist, it plops on out and taken on by Letang. Marches on for the Penguins, drops it back to Crosby, his shot saved, made by Vasilevsky. Was touched by a high stick and it skidded just wide. Played back on now by Crosby again, trying to worm his way away. Guided one around in front, and a falling shot is saved by Vasilevsky. What a try that came from Sheary. There were no goals until Brian Rust scored earlier in this period, 1-0 Penguins.
Right, shoot left, good save again from Vasilevsky, and then Sheary had a great chance right before that TV timeout off the pass from Crosby.
Drouin. Garrison must retrieve. Hawked there by Hagelin.
That's one way to win a faceoff for Tampa Bay. Nick Bonino, the center for the Penguins, had a stick up in the air when they dropped it.
Here's Philpott, but it's intercepted by Hagelin, and he charges ahead. Hagelin able to poke it right back along, and it trickles in on goal and is held by Vasilevsky.
No, Valtteri Filppula and Nick Bonino. There's the official. Look at Bonino's stick. Now he has a word with the official, and probably somewhere along the line is that everybody's here to watch us play, not you drop the puck. Not that I've ever used that line before, Doc.
I was going to say that sounded like the voice of experience.
I learned that from the centermen that came before me. And that was Benino's first loss in the faceoff dot.
One by Malkin, walked on by Letang, to Malkin again, around to Letang, off his stick, and it's Strom. Then Killorn, and then back. Dumoulin able to brush it on, and Rust takes over there. Stroman able to turn back. Away from Rust and the pass misfires. Malkin collars it there. Letang and Dumoulin. Directed on by Rust, flagged by Malkin, trickled back in, stymied by Strawman, and it's Hedman, but off of Letang. Gathered by Kucherov, and a nice stick check there by Dumoulin. Back ahead, now comes Kunitz. Wall to the corner by Strawman, puck came to Hedman, hunted down by Malkin, but too late. Turned on by Rust, and around behind to Hedman. Off the glove of Kunitz, and he got it back, and floated one, that went wide. Turned around behind for Strawman, then played by Kucherov, and it's fair, dropping on back.
Extended shift here for Hedman and Strawman.
Kunitz able to regather and start back in. Able to go by Strawman, hooked out a bit there, dropped around behind and shuffled off. Swatted on further and Hedman. Rolled it on around and Stamkos. Hunted down by Fair and shouldered there after he'd played it behind. Hedman trickled it ahead. Kucherov wanted to play further. The challenge from Mata. Turned over. Kunitz. Dragged free by Fair and a backhander is held by Vasilevsky. The forecheck has done a good job for the Penguins here tonight.
Well, Eddie talked about the extended shift for Hedman and Strawman. You're going to have extended shifts if guys can't chip the puck out. Aggressive forecheck play by Pittsburgh, no question. But the chip-outs by Tampa Bay have not been very good, just like their offensive zone or defensive zone face-offs have been very good. And there you see Eric Fair putting it on goal.
And a good play by Ole Mata to pinch in there to make sure that to keep that play alive. And look, you have to recognize as a player when you see guys, especially in the second period, the change, the long change in that second period, when guys are out there extended, got to keep them banged up. That was a high hit by Stamkos on Connor Sherry, and he's shaking up.
Along now with it comes Callahan. Here's Callahan swinging one right out front. Oh, and reaching away with the goal stick and then seeing it go loose, and now just regathering his goal stick was Matt Murray. Rushed along by Crosby, and here comes Hagelin moving in. Toe drag down to the ice he goes, and play continues. His backup with it is Filppula. Filppula moving on with a shot that's blocked wide by Ian Cole. Back up the boards, here's Hagelin again. Hornquist near the end of his shift, can't catch up, now moves in. Hornquist a shot, getting a piece of it is Vasilevsky. Rushed around now for Hagelin. Around behind, taken away by Cuckoo, and then punched by Bonino. Hagelin with it again. Thrown back along, and it is Cuckoo able to bring it ahead, and it's taken away by Bonino. Floated one that's knocked down by the defense. Still they play, and it started back up again. Having to hustle back now as Letang bringing it on is Drouin. Drifts to the slot with it. Drouin a shot, he scores! And the game is tied at one.
You talk about patience with the puck. Look at Jonathan Drouin, head up. Causing separation, move back the other way and go over the weak spot on Matt Murray. Top shelf over the glove, what a play. Little bit of a screen in front by Palat, but the great patience from Drouin.
And how about the line mates going to the net to back the defense off? Look where Filppula and Palat are, they don't stop. They drive to the net, keep going hard, back everybody off. And then Drouin can create time and space on Brian Dumoulin. He sees the guys go to the net, then he just plays off them. Brilliant play, Eddie. Bang on. High glove on that goaltender, Matt Murray. That's where Washington got to him a little bit, and that's where Tampa's got to get to him.
That's one of those plays as a shooter to be able to skate one way and then shoot back the other way with a little bit of oomph on it. And that puck was drifted by Jonathan Drouin.
Brought on by Malkin, dropped back for Kunitz, turned around and up. He needed help from center and got it from Mata. Then across to Lovejoy, blast one that goes wide. Hopped around now to Kunitz. Kunitz directed it over, Malkin able to get it there. Malkin able to settle it down and play it on back to Lovejoy once more. Lovejoy slung one that went wide, off the board.
Third goal in two games, jumps on that wayward shot that was actually planned by Lovejoy off the boards on the indirect, and Russ wins the race and puts it by Vasilevsky.
Watch this puck takes a funny bounce. Vasilevsky goes to grab it, and it goes off the side of the net. Almost a slingshot or a pinball type of bounce. It goes off the net under the glove of Vasilevsky, and then there is Rust. And puts it in between the left pad and the post. And what an answer by the Penguins.
It took 30 seconds between the second goal of the night and the third one. We have never had a 1-1 tie in this series. But we had one, though it didn't last long. Penguins back ahead in this game. Paquette nudges it on, unable to reach it, Garrison. Paquette gave it up to Kunockle, and he brings it back. Kunockle turning now, trying to get around behind. Shoved off there by Garrison. Rolled off of that. Wanted to point it to Cole, but instead it's Boyle. Paquette able to pitch it back in. Curled around the boards and out to get it is Murray, just away from JT Brown. Up the boards, chopped by Fair. Tucked on across safely to Cole. 9:10 to go, second period, game seven. Penguins have had 2-1 goal leads. Hornquist turned it along, circling is Crosby. Crosby to Letang, and a save, rebound! Oh, and it's poked away by Vasilevsky, as on the doorstep was Hornquist, and a race on for this one. Murray guides it away, and Letang hands it on to Dumoulin. Crosby shook it across. Sheary able to dart ahead with it now. To the outside, a shot, guided away. Crosby has it. A lot of puck possession for the Penguins here. Turned along to Sheary. Rocked a little bit by Cuckoo. Fed one to Hornquist, and the shot would not go.
Good effort there from Sheary.
Sheary, who was shaken up on a hit earlier, right back out there on the next shift. This is Dumoulin, able to bank it back around. Crosby speared it loose there. Bothered by Hetman, Crosby able to turn away. Guided one on back, Letang has it. Letang for Crosby, directed up high and off the short glass by Hetman. Charging ahead now is Drouin, watched by Dumoulin, who flicked it away and back to center. Fresh from the bench now, it is Bonino, and he lobbed it back in. It's stopped by Vasilevsky. Under 8 minutes to go, second period, game seven. A non-stop roar. Icing is called and the faceoff will come back.
Now the Penguins are up 2-1. Watch Ben Lovejoy. He's looking to shoot that wide on purpose because people are in the lane. There's the crazy carom we were alluding to. And Brian Rust jumps on it.
Thrown by Callahan, but we get all of this called back. It had been played by a high stick.
Get your more consistent offense against the Penguins.
Well, you know what? I think the first period, we kind of dictated what we wanted. What, a little bit of feeling out process, not sure what's going on. We got plays to make and we're not making them. And we're staying in our zone a little too much, kind of feeding their energy. We bounced back nice on the goal score. It was tough to get one up there, but lots of game left. We're not worried.
Excellent, John. Right.
Penguins abbreviated power play about a half minute earlier, had no shots on goal. Callahan the high stick. And so with the 2-1 lead, a man advantage, and Walken walks it across. One-time shot by Crosby was wide. Letang grubbed it around, and it curled over to Crosby. Stroman defending with Hedman. Up front are Filppula and Killorn. Give it on now to Hornquist. Right around in front, a backhander. And that one flew just past Kessel and the Kane. Taken on by Letang. Off the boards. Scooped up by Malkin. Drive! And that one was tipped past the glove hand of Vasilevsky. And we get a stoppage of play as it went out of play.
Eddie and Doc, watch Andre Vasilevsky. Quick puck movement by the Penguins. He's going to be over, and then Crosby's just going to rip it up. And Vasilevsky's almost like, wow, I can't believe that came to me that quick.
And a little bit of a screen by Victor Hedman as well, but the element of surprise from Sidney Crosby. Watch for Kessel to be looking for, if they get the puck on Phil Kessel's side, so the right of Vasilevsky, looking for Crosby on the weak side, the opposite side of Kessel.
Here's Crosby with it, gives it on to Malkin. Then Crosby, then Malkin. Crosby and Malkin play catch inside the box. Hornquist, that one is knocked down by Palat Battleport, and clear but not out, and then a sling right on goal by Kessel. Had to be answered by the pad of Vasilevsky, and now it's clear.
Good effort there from Brian Boyle to get that puck, settle it down, and clear it.
Halfway through the penalty kill, and an important one for the Lightning. Crosby shook it back in and went in to get it. It is Boyle, but then it's Malkin. Then it's Letang, drifting and giving to Malkin. Screen set up in front. Watching is Kessel as Malkin has it. Outside to Crosby. Shot! And that deflected up high and out of play.
Well, we talked about Phil Kessel and Sidney Crosby. Now, here's where the puck is. What the Penguins are trying to get accomplished is to get here, have somebody run out, and then move that puck back door to Sidney Crosby, but the Lightning are there. Kessel gets it and decides, you know what? It's a broken play because Malkin is trying to get that puck all the way over to Kessel. So they're trying to move it through the middle of the ice once and then throw it right back to the far side where it came from for an open net there on that weak side, the opposite side of the puck for Crosby.
Filppula won it from Bonino and it's cleared back down by Hedman. And so Murray will tend in the last half minute of this power play. 6:05 to go, second period of game seven. Across it comes now to Schultz, trying to get by Hedman. Schultz able to burrow back in, but it's taken over by Filppula. Given away, though, near Sheary, as Killorn just couldn't handle the pass. And it's brushed along now, and here's Kunitz. Chris Kunitz around behind. To the outside it came to Bonino. On back to Dumoulin. One-timer by Schultz! And that one deflected up to the glass. Played on back now to Dumoulin. Schultz again! Save! Rebound! No! Blocked by Hedman! A great play by the defenseman for the Lightning, and it's covered eventually by Vasilevsky. Only three goals have been scored. 30 shots taken, 22 by the Penguins. 3-0 in the series. Mario Gosselin, Steve Penny, Cam Ward, and Ryan Miller, two brilliant goaltenders in the conference final of 06. And this one, 21 years old, both of them at the start of the series. Matt Murray celebrated birthday 22 yesterday. Matt Cullen on the draw with Valtteri Filppula, who prevailed.
How about that chance from Connor Sheary, Victor Hedman. One stop, and then Vasilevsky on Sheary. Or a second chance opportunity right from the blue paint.
Stacked his pads, didn't
they? They did.
Garrison a shot, and that one skittered wide. Can be played back along now by Killorn. Killorn turns it on now for Drouin. Popped right back out again by Cullen. Trying to pull a stick free and drawing a penalty. Kunoffel drive, and that's sent wide by Drouin. And now there'll be a penalty. Drouin will be taking a minor penalty if that is the only one. It's a stick hold.
High risk hockey, Killorn and Drouin. Look how aggressive the Penguins are. They try to play a little scheme on the boards. Aggressive stick play by Matt Cullen, creating a foot race for Kunacko and Drouin. The damage is already done for Jonathan Drouin. Kelly Sutherland saw the holding of the stick and he goes to the box.
Tom Kunacko's hustle drew the penalty. In all these years, I have never known a team with a nickname the Cannibals, but Tom Kunacko played for a team in Germany. When he was 16, it was a senior team. He still has the jersey. Power play is on, bringing this on is Letang. Then back to Kessel, side of the net play, off the pad of Vasilevsky by Hornquist. Carried right back ahead by Boyle and turned aside by the stick of Matt Murray. That becomes the eighth shot on goal. Or perhaps ninth. We're going to get a penalty coming up here. It's going to be on Chris Letang, and again, it will be 4-4.
Good board play by Andre Palat. Brian Boyle keeps the play alive, and Palat takes the puck off the wall and tries to beat Letang to the inside part of the ice. He does it right in front of Wes McCauley, and that's a no-no.
Palat has had an outstanding game here. You look up at the shot clock, and The Tampa Bay Lightning with only 8. Pittsburgh Penguins with 25. Palat has had a strong game for John Cooper and the Tampa Bay Lightning. So back to 4-on-4, man on man. The forwards have the defense, the defense have the forwards. Look for defensemen to get involved and try to turn a 1-on-1 into a 2-on-1 somewhere in the offensive zone.
Reached by Schuster. Is out there with Garrison, who wanted it. And then it is Hagelin testing with him. Hagelin able to push it back now, and it's Lovejoy. Lovejoy twirled it around behind, and it struck the back of the net before coming to Dumoulin. Laid ahead for Hagelin, charges back up with Bonino. Hagelin moving around now, curls around behind. Hagelin looked for Dumoulin, and then Hagelin a shot out of the glove of Vasilevskiy, taken by Bonino. Scramble in front as that attempt swift across the net mouth wide and could not be gotten by Hagelin because of Johnson. So now Schuster weaving his way and then blasting one back in. Off the outside of the net, and it will require help from Matt Murray, who's bumped into by Kucherov, and the puck outletted now to Crosby. Carried right back by Kessel, gains the zone, but it's left behind. Sent right back along, and a chance now for Stamkos. Drive! Save! Made it! And skipped wide off of Murray. It is Crosby across to Dumoulin, who doubles back. Along by Kessel, flipped along by Crosby, and offside is called.
The long change in the second period. Next thing you know, Steven Stamkos is in. The pass from Alec Killorn, head up all the way. Stamkos just not able to beat Matt Murray. Look at the positioning of the goaltender. He's out. There's some room in between the blocker and the right hip, and he just gets enough.
Carl Hagelin's had a spectacular game. Eddie was talking about Andre Palat. Look at Bonino fight off Harrison and eventually, or Garrison, excuse me, and eventually the chance down low for Hagelin. He didn't stay to the outside.
It is Strahlman dropping it along and right to Malkin. Here's Malkin feeding it on back. Schultz got it over. Modest shot skipped off Philpott and went wide. And a penalty coming up. It's going to be on Hedman. Delayed call. Hedman without a stick now as Schultz's shot pops on back and is settled down by Crosby. Drew it back into Vasilevskiy. Crosby set back down. Meanwhile, play is stopped and there'll be a penalty call. It'll be 4-on-4 for 19 seconds and then a power play to the Penguins.
Well, Victor Hedman's wondering why he gets the penalty when his stick breaks. And Malkin picks up his stick, and Hedman's is the one that is split in two. And there you see, palms up. And at the end of that play, Sidney Crosby, the smarts of Crosby, recognizing, get the puck in, get a whistle. We'll have a little bit more time on the man advantage, the power play. Once Letang comes out, and then Andre Palat just buried Crosby right in front of Pierre. So 4-on-4 hockey here for 19 seconds.
It's a game 7. And when you anticipate this, you think of a lot of things, but you hope it's dramatic and you hope it's close. And so far it's been both. Braden Coburn with this. Veteran defenseman brings it ahead and doubles back. In 8 seconds, his team will be shorthanded. Right now, it's both teams a man short. Strahlman a shot, carefully grabbed and held by Matt Murray.
Good idea there from Strahlman. It actually looked like that puck was kind of end over end. Once it left the stick of Strahlman, might have popped out of the glove of Murray when the shot leaves the stick. Yeah, and he ends up catching it on the rebound.
Shots are 27-10. But the deficit in goals, that's the important one, is only 1. Offensive zone faceoff. Boyle has been pretty strong. But this one kicked to the front. Malkin rescues to Schultz, returning it to Malkin. And now penalty time goes up pretty big against the Lightning because it's a power play for the Penguins and Malkin tried to shake through. The Lightning have been strong in penalty killing, particularly here in Pittsburgh in this series. But along with this now is Hornquist, got it across, drive by Malkin. Boy, that's just a lightning-like move made by the goaltender for the Lightning in Andre Vasilevsky.
Well, Andre Schuster's got to fire this puck out of the zone. He's trying to make a pass to Brian Boyle with Sidney Crosby all over him. And then there's the opportunity for Malkin. Schuster gets that net. You got to be the eyes of that intended receiver of the pass in Boyle. If you see somebody stepping up on him, you got to fire that puck off the glass.
Especially being a right-hand shot there. He's on his forehand.
Bill Pelosi sent it back down, and Murray will watch it there. Murray with a gentle shove, it comes right to Philpola, and Philpola centered one that was poked away as Callahan made a thrust at it. Pulled off by Kessel and nubbed on back. And Malkin kicks to control. And dropped it back over for Kessel. Kessel sent it on across, taken by Hornquist, and then onto the back to Letang. 45 to go on the power play, a minute 50 to go, second period. Letang faked the drive. And again, and shoves one that's tipped aside by Strawman. Got by Hornquist, side of the net, Kessel can't get it by! Spalling across with Strawman, and it's dumped back down the ice. Fresh group of Lightning are out there. Boyle and Palat, as well as Garrison and Strawman. On with it, Kunitz, hands on to Bonino. Bonino with a shot, and that held to the chest of Vasilevsky, who has been strong.
Boy, Vasilevsky was down early here, Doc. What an opportunity for Phil Kessel and Patrick Hornquist right before that. But watch Nick Bonino and look at Vasilevsky. The shot's on its way, and look at where he is. He's down on his knees even before that puck leaves the stick. And there's that opportunity. Hornquist to Kessel. Good job there from Strawman to deny that opportunity on the power play.
This one is picked up by Garrison, and a good play there defensively with 10 seconds left on his team's penalty kill. It's Brian Rust, and then it's sent back down. Rust with both Penguins goals. Drouin with the only goal for the Lightning. 2-1 in favor of Pittsburgh here as we're down to the final minute of the period. Penalty time is up. It's brought on by Dumoulin. Dumoulin's pass is broken up and started back up by Johnson. Now along comes Palat. He's got Hedman fresh from the box with him. And Palat had it blocked away by Dumoulin back to center. And it's flopped on back. Dumoulin to the corner chasing this with Johnson. Ties up there. Help came from Matt Cullen. Racing in is Kucherov, but it's around behind now to Lovejoy. Scaled it back along and down, and it will become an icing. Follow the Stanley Cup playoffs live with the official NHL app. Stay connected with in-game highlights, news, scores, and more. Download the official NHL app today for your phone and tablet. This time it is Johnson to take an important draw. 31.7 to go, and it's in his team's offensive end. Shots 21-5 in this period in favor of the Penguins. Chances 11-3. But it's only a 2-1 game. Here's Strawman with it. Shooting one, and that one blocked right back and taken by Kunitz. But it caromed on back where it had to be helped out by Dumoulin and carried on by Cullen. Cullen drifting with it now, waiting for reinforcements, dropped it in hoping for Rust, but Strawman was there. Anton Strawman held off by Rust. Kunockel trying to jab it free in the final seven of the period. And it is Johnson. And that's two in game seven. A disagreement, but they part. 2-1 Penguins after two. Liam, Mike, and Keith coming up on the Discover Card Intermission Report. They say that rookie Rust is playing like a veteran, and Vasilevsky is keeping...
was very passionate, and he was a tad out there, but I think that's what made him such a great character. Not only is a head coach in the National Hockey League, but in the greatest game in the world at every level.
Eddie and Doc, don't you think he was happiest riding the buses with his players after long games? I mean, I coached against him in the minors. He just loved being with his players on the bus.
He would certainly love this game, as competitive as it's been. 2-1, and here comes Hedman, and his shot had to be shouldered away by Matt Murray to get this period underway with the first shot and the first save. Full strength action, no carryover penalties nor power plays. as it is Strawman taking it. Do you sense any adjustments here by Tampa Bay in the third? You think they'll shake up lines? Here comes Drouin moving ahead with it now. Drops it on back. Garrison is shot, and a butterfly save is made there by Murray. Back to Garrison again, and that one well wide, and flying to it is Haglund, and chops it up high and on back.
You can already tell there's a little bit of a different jump in their step, just the way that they're coming through the middle of the ice.
Remember back to game six, they were terrible for 40, and they were real good the last 20.
Nemesnikov played it ahead, dug out by Stamkos and flipped off of Malkin, who regathered. Game seven, best of seven. Winner goes to the Stanley Cup Final against San Jose. Tumbling down Malkin, play continues. It's brought back up by Colbert. Up the wing, Callahan fires, and that deflected wide as getting in the way was Ian Cole. This one bounced on now for a lead pass to Rust. Going for the hat trick. Lost it off his stick, defended, and then it's shoved wide by Malkin. Dragged on around now by Kunitz.
No stick for Vasilevsky.
It is in the corner about 45 feet away, and we get a stoppage of play and a faceoff in the Tampa Bay end.
Ryan Rust is becoming a superhero to Pittsburgh Penguins fans because of his speed and escapability. Quality chance working on Braden Coburn. Another chance for Malkin. Look at Coburn. He doesn't want to take a penalty there. He's lucky he wasn't called for holding. Malkin beats Slater cuckoo to the net. Another opportunity. Vasilevsky fights it off. And it is in, and Doc said, no stick for Vasilevsky after that collision, but play carried on.
Yeah, Malkin wants to know why there was no penalty on Slater cuckoo on that second chance opportunity.
They moved the faceoff back to center, which drew a discussion. Regardless of that, it's Strawman there. Played along by Crosby. Then Hedman, close quarters, Strawman. Hedman again, but then it is Sheary. Sheary came up with it. Wedged off behind by Tyler Johnson, who's done a lot of work back deep in his own defensive end tonight. Crosby wedged off there right near Pierre by Killorn. It's brought back by Letang. Again, it's Vasilevsky's puck to play, and he does so to Strom. 2:10 played in the third period of Game 7. The Penguins have had 2 one-goal leads, no scoring until the second. J.T. Brown with a shot that's blocked away by Schultz. Canceled behind by Brown, but played back off by Lovejoy. Stopped by Garrison, menaced enough by Fair that it can be played back out again by Matt Cullen.
I think it's pretty simple from John Cooper and the Tampa Bay Lightning. Anytime they get the puck over the blue line, it's going towards the net. Just like that play. The mindset for every player that has entered the zone for the Tampa Bay Lightning is to get the puck to the net. So most importantly, the guys without the puck have to recognize that and then drive inside the dots and maybe look for a rebound or a redirect if you can beat that puck to the front of the net.
Same formula we saw in game six. Very same, shoot from anywhere. Lynn races to the net.
Matt Murray peers out at this faceoff that will involve Bonino and Filppula. Two of the best in the game tonight. One by Filppula, touched by Palat, on back to Schuster. And a shot and a sliding stop by Bonino. And a diving play by Mata, but it can't be cleared out by Haglund. Thrown by Garrison, and it's tipped up high over the glove hand of Murray. Now it's Palat throwing one around in front, and flopped down. They try to stash it to the front of the net, no luck. Played on by Crosby, but not out. It's Drouin up and with it again. Toe drag, couldn't get the shot away. Another backhand shot went off a skate wide. And Haglund hurries. Drouin again. A lot of pressure, Tampa Bay now. Drouin holding, looking across. Got it onto the back to Garrison, a shot, and that ricocheted wide. Played out in front by Drouin. Drouin circles to the outside, a restlessness in the crowd. A one-time shot by Garrison, blocked away and injured on the play is Lovejoy. He remains down and the whistle will be blown. Ben Lovejoy, I beg your pardon, that is Bonino, 13, not 12 Lovejoy, who is down and needing help. And we'll get help to the bench.
Well, that's a shot from Jason Garrison after Jonathan Drouin was playing a game of keep away all by himself. But a couple of great opportunities. Drouin tries a curl and drag, the good stick from Olimata, and then the giveaway from Haglin. And just continue to fire the puck at the net. Look at that, off the right skate, redirected by Beltieri. Philpott off the left pad of Matt Murray.
Don Cooper, you saw at the Tampa Bay bench, has won at every level of hockey he's coached, including all three levels of junior hockey, and then the American Hockey League, with many of these players in Norfolk, Virginia. Moved on to Syracuse for part of a season and then joined the Lightning. Got them to the final last year. Across this come to Letang. Steps in and lobs one that's waffle-boarded away to the corner by Vasilevsky. Given up back to the point, though. Dumoulin a shot, and that gonged away by Vasilevsky. And back in. Well, it's a part of the equipment, I guess you use it. Here's Coburn playing it back up. Talorn flipping it ahead. Kucherov had it denied there, and it winds up becoming an offside. Well, we don't know the opponent in these, well, go ahead.
Okay, Doc, well, we know the San Jose Sharks will be in the Stanley Cup Final. We know that game one will be Monday night, 8 p.m. Eastern on NBC. We also know that our coverage will begin at 6 p.m. Eastern on NBCSN. What we don't know is where we're going to start. Tampa wins, we'll be in San Jose for games one and two. If the Penguins win, we'll be right here in the Berg for games one and two. So stay tuned.
One by Crosby, played by the defense. Schultz got it ahead and deflected back down, and icing is called. Quite a list, isn't it? Multiple goals in a game seven by a rookie, and Brian Rust has joined the list. Adam Henrique of New Jersey, Brad Marchand of Boston, Jeremy Roenick of Chicago twice, Craig Janney of Boston, Mel Bridgman of Philadelphia, Milan Marcetta of the Minnesota North Stars, Eddie Mazur of the Montreal Canadiens in the days of six teams. Philpola won that to Palat, handed back to Strawman, and then along it is taken once more by Palat, handed off of Strawman, and then near Schultz. Palat again, Hornquist again, can't get it by Drouin. Battled it further, and eventually it comes by, but Hedman was watching there and sent it back down, and an icing is called. You could sense nervousness on the part of the fans. And now it comes back to the offensive end, and so they can relax for a moment. 15:38 to go in the third period of the seventh game, and their team ahead by one. Malkin waiting in here with Philpola, and Malkin won it back. Here's Lovejoy, threw one to the side, and it is taken and thrown across the net mouth wide by Kessel. Now Palat, Malkin harassing him from behind. Palat able to fire one that was knifed down, and then played again by Mata. Went on through, poked along by Haglin, grabbed by Philpola, and Philpola is able to duck on back as his team makes a change. Slater Cuckoo returns it to him. Poked away by Fair. Domestnikov shoved down by Mata. Took it away and threw it off Domestnikov again. To the bench comes Malkin on a shift change. 5 minutes have been played here in the third. Spiked across to Cuckoo. Trying to get there but can't. Lifted along right back into Cuckoo again by Lovejoy. Two aside continue the battle, and it's Matt Cullen this time. Prevailing and sending it by the referee. Played by Fair, but into Steven Stamkos. Stamkos able to drag it around behind. Turns to the outside with it now. Stamkos got it back. Cuckoo there. Flung it wide, hoping for a bounce. It came over to Callahan. Rocked there, and it's worked on off of Callahan. He's able to step away with it. Tried to get it to Stamkos. Lifted along, kept alive by Colbert, and floated to the corner. Around it's Domestnikov. Shoulders there with Schultz. More battling by Stamkos. Two aside go to work on it. Thrown all the way back down. There'll be no icing on this one. And so Vasilevsky with the long pass. Shift change for both teams. Callahan still out there, able to charge on with it. Double teamed by the Penguins. Poked along by Letang. Second effort, got it onto Hornquist. Then Sheary. One man back, it's Garrison as Sheary brings it on. Tries to get to the front, backhand. Alexander, shut off. Meanwhile, the rebound goes around behind, and Sheary giving a jolt there as he tries to reach. Pulled away by Alex Killorn, fed back up, and Johnson is able to skip one along, and they can get a change of personnel. Letang's pass directed back in by Sheary, read by Schuster. Bothered there by Hornquist, and he's got trouble, but he got help from Johnson. Then back up for Garrison, who brings it on 6.5 play. On out of Kucherov, fed one across, but it came all the way to the boards, and it's brought back up and carried on by Letang. Moves in, he's got rest on the wing. High with the shot. Then along it's Malkin. Malkin trying to play once more. Two chances for Rust here. Shot by Lovejoy, and that ricocheted off Rust. Now Letang. Then it's Kunitz. Out of the chaos of the third period, game 7. Lovejoy hands it over. Rust with it there. Rust able to pivot along. Dropped it back over to Malkin. Dropped it around behind for Rust. Right out in front, save. Rebound covered by Vasilevsky, and play is stopped. You're watching the NHL Stanley Cup playoffs.
From Jason Garrison, to give Kucherov that chance. And good news for the Penguins, Nick Bonino back on the bench.
Just after, arriving back, yeah, good eye.
After blocking that shot.
To the back, on a shot, getting a stick on it was Vasilevsky. Another try out in front, Cullen whacking away, can't get a shot. Tumbling down with Phil Pellett, taking it along is Hagelin. Rolled it around, right out in front, poked away from Kessel. Hagelin up with it again. Hagelin able to step away. Dropped it back along for Kessel. Denied, though, by Hedman. He's able to step by and shuffleboard one out to center. Mata turned it along, having to go after it as Lovejoy. Lovejoy whacked it along further. Here's Drouin. Settled down by Palat, given back to Hedman. Holds it there, watched by Hagelin. Given over to Strom, and a shot! And that is into the glove of Matt Murray.
Well, Matt Murray at one end, Olli Maatta at another. Strahlman had the shot, but how about Olli Maatta at the other end, putting this puck through? That just gets fought off by the right shoulder. Anton Strahlman at the other end, he blasts it on goal, and Matt Murray, big as a house with that catching glove.
Pierre, I know your son's a wonderful forward. If he'd have asked to play goal, would you have let him?
No.
There's too much pressure with this, isn't
there? My brother played goal, and my mom never went to watch him.
It's hard to watch sometimes, but it's fun to watch when it's dramatic like this. After it now comes Kucherov, dropped it back on, and Killorn couldn't come up with it. Dumoulin could, but right on him is Killorn. Around it came for the pop back up off of Bonino, challenged by Garrison, and it's Dumoulin the other way this time. Cuckoo able to keep it alive. Good work by the Lightning to keep play in the Pittsburgh end. It's Killorn, but then Bonino, then Johnson, and then on back it's Cuckoo, who must play at center. 8.25 played in the third period of game 7. A one-goal game. The Penguins have had a pair of one-goal leads, 2 goals by Brian Rust, 1 by Jonathan Drouin for the Tampa Bay Lightning. Pumped right back in and settled down by Kunitz, who roars back out with it. Kunitz advancing on Cuckoo, wanting to go by, cannot. They cancel. It's played along by Killorn. On back to Cuckoo, who reconnects with Alex Killorn. The Harvard guy plays it on out. It's off a high stick, but play will continue until now.
Well, after winning the Preakness, can Exaggerator capture the final jewel of the Triple Crown? The Belmont Stakes country begins June the 10th, right here on NBCSN, leading up to the big race Saturday, the 11th of June, on NBC.
Would that be equivalent to the buckets of oats they gave that horse for winning? 35-14, 21-5 in the second period. Are the shots on goal, the ones that would have been goals had they not been stopped by the goaltender, or were goals? Matt Murray hung on to that one.
You know, men, we had another game where it was 41-21. We had another game where it was 48-28, all in favor of the Penguins. This has been the storyline for the Pittsburgh Penguins. They're out shooting Tampa. More times than not, they're out skating Tampa, and their speed is forcing a ton of turnovers and making Tampa very uncomfortable, Eddie and Doc.
As we talked about earlier, Pierre, that Pittsburgh Penguins have been the better team over the course of the first six-plus games in his series, but here we are in a game seven because a great equalizer, the guy in goal, has kept his team around to get to the seventh game.
Off the tie-up, it's pulled off by Fair, rolls it back out, tries to get there, but instead it is Hedman. Gliding around behind, pursued by Kunockel, and then by Fair, who knocked it loose. Kunockel able to play it back, Stroman right in there, experienced on defense to deal with him. Rolled on around to Matt Cullen, popped on high, moving in is Schultz. Then Cullen rocked off there by Boyle. Down is Hedman, shoved off is Kunockel. Played onto the back to Ian Cole, and a wrister is knocked down in front, and Boyle lobbed it on, but it's taken by Cullen, but followed up by Hedman. Edmonds passes on the money now for Callahan, who spins. Throws one that careened across, right around in front! And it bounced on now for Mata, who cleared it back out. What a strange change of possession there. Icing is called against the Penguins.
Now the stretch pass to Ryan Callahan. He knows the artillery's coming to support him. So he spins out of it, moves the puck. The big reach by Victor Hedman. Look where Stamkos and Boyle, the third time in this game, Stamkos has been behind the Pittsburgh Penguin defense and wasn't able to score.
Good job there from Ole Mata to tie up Ryan Boyle. Not giving him opportunity to get a whack at that loose puck.
Scoring chances are 20-9 in favor of the Penguins. Brian Rust has six of the 20 and two goals. Garrison has to retrieve this one. Handcuff Cuckoo with that pass, so it'll be more conventionally played behind the net. And more trouble. So now Cuckoo. Filppula brings it on and hands it over for Palat to bring in. Palat's shot was slowed down. Battled for behind. Filppula there. Took some swats from Mata. Puck taken on, and Haglund jams it back down. Another change in lines for the Penguins. 9 3/4 minutes to go. An intercept by Crosby. Able to step right back with it and gain the zone. Drops it over for Sheary. And that one snapped up and held by Vasilevsky. 9:40 to go. Third period, game seven. A one-goal game, the Penguins by one. In English, but he knows his priorities, and he has been impressive.
Actions speak louder than words, and he has been just that.
Letang, Coburn, Hornquist, Crosby. Near Sheary, but Johnson. Sailed,
finally
out of play, and a minor.
Kucherov, not sure if this puck is on edge when he lets it go, yeah. He almost double hits it. And you look at the eyes, they're watching.
It's that aggressive forecheck that has not gone away. The Pittsburgh Penguins have been relentless. And the guys for Tampa know it when they're deep in their own zone. They can't be comfortable with the puck.
Gold rush of towels, a tradition in Pittsburgh. A lot of places, but very famous here. Schultz goes to work on the power play with Letang. Filppula on the kill with Callahan, Hedman, and Stroman.
Two defensemen out here for the Penguins. Usually it's four and one, four forwards and one D. Playing it safe by Mike Sullivan.
Hedman lifted along by Filppula. Stopped by Letang and handed on to Malkin. Crosby with Kessel, and now it's brought by Schultz and given on to Kessel. Poked on back to Schultz. Waits, shoveled one, and that one turned aside. Played on now by Crosby to Malkin. Schultz again, and that one was off of Kessel, who staggers, but is back to his feet. Malkin across, Kessel shovels it back, and Letang gives it on to Schultz. Letang a shot, and that one went wide. Dropping to block that was Callahan. Malkin again, on to Crosby. Safe play to Malkin. All attack time for the Penguins right now. Schultz sweeps it across, Letang has it there. Back to Schultz again. Malkin a drive, and that off the knee of Hedman. Crosby popped it loose, Hedman tries to play it. Crosby is able to take it away, stick out of Hedman's hand. Crosby then along to Malkin. Malkin circles, no stick for Hedman. No stick for Crosby. He goes to the bench to get one. All of that delay, and now Crosby can return. Balkan again. Filppula with no stick because he's given it over to Hedman. A drive is sealed up by Vasilevsky. 25 seconds still to kill for the Lightning.
Oh, lots going on. The stick on stick by Crosby. Remember, Hedman got a penalty earlier in the game for breaking his own stick on Evgeny Malkin. And the handoff there from Filppula, as you picked up on, Doc, to Hedman.
Bonino and Boyle for this faceoff with 7:47 to go, 25 seconds left on the penalty kill to the Tampa Bay Lightning. Sent to the back to Mata. Drifts, shot one, high and blocked down. Taken away by Mata from Boyle. Around to get it as Kunitz, closed off by Garrison. Taken by Sheary and handed on back. Mata twirls with it there. Got it on over for Dumoulin. Dumoulin, a shot deflected away by Schuster. Played along again by Kunitz. Gets the return, but it's in the path of Garrison, who tried to play, could not. Bonino forced it behind. Schuster took over there. Penalty time is up. Kucherov is out of the box. A long toss ahead, and here comes Boyle. Moving right around. Couldn't get it home. A bad stop is made by Murray.
Two goals in game six for Boyle, and he almost had one there in game seven.
Of Kucherov, reached by Fair, but he couldn't control. Kucherov steps back in, under seven to go. Laid it to the back, couldn't be stopped by Coburn. Could by Cuckoo, but he played it off Fair. And we get a stoppage of play and an offside.
A quick strike for Brian Boyle in game number six. Takes that pass from Palat, driving on Letang. Letang doesn't want to take a penalty, so he's doing his best not to, and the right pad comes out from Matt Murray.
Yeah, just not able to turn that blade over, and instead of bringing that puck on an angle towards the net to bring it over laterally to keep it away from the goaltender, because Boyle's trying to hold off Letang to give himself some leverage there, and not able to get a lot on that puck towards the young goaltender.
Terry Filppula dodges one and moves it on in. Filppula, watched by Mata, glides around behind. Circles to the outside. What has he got? Back for a shot by Coburn that's deflected. Now Cuckoo threw one. That bounced across. Gruan retrieves. Slams on the brakes. Wiped out. Had to get as far as center. Taken away by Sheary. Staggers, but he comes on in. Sheary backhander getting a piece of it was Vasilevsky. Battled for some more with 6:10 to go. Penguins in the midst of making a player change. Palat able to bring it ahead. Couldn't get it by Malkin. Malkin dropped it on. Kunitz is taken out of the play by Drouin. These Lightning have been out there quite a while now. It is knocked along by Russ to the corner. Coburn goes in after it. Gets it on to Cuckoo. Cuckoo flopped one ahead that comes back to center. Maybe the Lightning can get a change. Rifled right back in again. Vasilevsky stops it. It on. Stamkos trying to play it there, could not. Dumped back out by Cole. They are all standing. Nothing orchestrated by the scoreboard. The Let's Go Pens chant, but ahead comes Johnson. Ever dangerous, plays it back in. Lovejoy ran into the net, and the net is dislodged, and play is stopped. 5:03 to go, third period. A ton of chances since this became 2-1. This just one more, but after their victory today, said now we need the Penguins to win one tonight. They are watching from their hotel in Dallas. The fans celebrate with the towels, but it's too early to really celebrate because the Lightning have had impressive strikes, no pun intended at all, in this series. Not all the Gunners are out there right now. The big boys come later. 5:03, lots of time to go here in the third. From the kick to control, after it is Lovejoy, and it's sent back out. Retrieved by Strollman, watched by Kunockel. Then Filppula, but fair, and nudged on back to Hedman. Strollman ahead, played in by Killorn. Stepping back for it, Lovejoy, Filppula on him. Strollman settles it down, rocked there by Matt Cullen. Punched on by Hedman, settled down and lifted back off the short glass and highlight further by Kunockel. Stepping back in with it is Hedman, right on goal, covered by Matt Murray, and a snow spray follows that.
Anton Strollman got hurt on that last sequence. He's on the bench and he was laboring. It was his lower body. Yeah, he was having a tough time getting off the ice. See, down in the corner, he pinches down, and then it's a leg-on-leg collision with Matt Cullen, and eventually the rollover by Cullen on Strollman, who's recovering from a broken leg.
Did they ever miss him over that 7 weeks that he was not there? Just as Trevor Daley has been missed in this series by the Penguins. But it becomes a war of attrition. 4:26 to go, third period. Deficit for the Lightning is one. One by Johnson, but it'll have to be played back out. Garrison and then Cuckoo. Garrison and Cuckoo. Palat. Cuckoo. And out. And in. Near Dumoulin. Turned with Johnson. Wedged along, Cuckoo there. Sent away from Hornquist and again back out. Bent across for Palat. Palat gave back for Kucherov, then around for Cuckoo. Around behind, rocked a bit there by the checking of Ben Lovejoy. Five players scrum, it kicked back out to Rust. Feathered it back off the boards as far as center and went to get it. Battled it free, he had Kunitz open, but he couldn't play it to him because of Kucherov. Filtered it across now to Schuster with under 3.5 to go. Back in it comes, and it's got by Killorn, who twisted one that bounced around in front and can be played now by Stamkos. Stamkos had it taken away by Fair and cleared back.
Oh, that puck took a funny bounce around Matt Murray off the simple little chip in by the Lightning.
They might try that again. Here's Hedman, though, carrying and backhanding one around in front. It's spiked away and sent back out again by Letang. 3 minutes to go. Hedman holds. Couldn't flip it past Kunockel. Across to Schuster. Then Hedman. Filppula is out along with Namestnikov and Drouin. Popped up to Namestnikov. Challenge there. Swept along and played back out again. Curling with it now is Braden Coburn. Shuffles it off now for Hedman. Pulls away from Haglund. Tried to get it ahead. It is taken off by Hornquist, and now it winds up being just a battle of feet and inches. Coburn yet again. Gave it on back to Drouin. Harassed by Hornquist, he pulls away. Drouin gains the zone. Able to keep it. Drops it on back to the point to Cuckoo. 2:07 to go. Dropped to the outside, touched behind by Drouin. Taken there and thrown along by Garrison. Gotten by Bonino, but he can't clear. Poked along by Matt Cullen of the Penguins. Bonino trying to kick it along to a side battle. Under 2 minutes to play. Onto the back it comes to Drouin. Slings one that slowed down and punched back out again by Bonino. Most of the fans are standing here. Twisted back across to Cuckoo. Led back up for the jab back in, and Letang has it. Still in the goal is Vasilevsky. Cuckoo denied though by Rust. Poked back further by Kunitz. Cuckoo yet again. In traffic for Steeper. Crosby takes over there. Drags it around behind. Kucherov and Crosby. And now it's Cuckoo again. Along it comes to Palat. Palat flipped it. Crosby took it. Palat back again. 1.25 to go. Vasilevsky at the hash mark. marks, looking to the bench. Should he come off? Now he does. The net's empty at the other end. Puck is thrown around there by Bonino. Kept alive by Hedman. One-time drive, pinballed off a player from each side. Stamkos ripped it in behind. Johnson touched it up the boards. Hedman got it there. Poked it on back. Kucherov able to hang on to it and drop it back off. Hedman able to have it. Kucherov in drive. Kicked around in front. Spin back out. And down by Letang. It will become an icing. Asked for a timeout. Presented by Gatorade Cross. It is the drama of a game seven, and then it is the action. Furious all around the net. It's thoroughly enjoyable if you're a fan of one of the 28 other teams. But if you're the fan of one of these two, you're reaching for Mailox long ago.
Well, the reminders on both sides. For the Penguins, one lost draw. Same thing for the Tampa Bay Lightning. You have the extra attacker. This team runs as many faceoff plays at even strength, let alone when they have the goaltender out, than any team in the National Hockey League. Maybe the New York Rangers might have more. But if it's a lost, or it's a stall faceoff of 50-50, if you're the Lightning, you're looking to come in and try to bump that puck back to either Hedman or Stamkos. Five forwards on the ice for the Lightning. One defenseman.
Johnson against Bonino for the draw.
If Bonino gets kicked out, they'd have Matt Cullen in reserve on the ice.
Encroachment by both Hagelin and Drouin. They are both worn back. One by Johnson. Can he get there? No, Hagelin has it. Hagelin pitches one. Stamkos goes back for it. Also back is Cullen. The two of them tie up, and it's dragged free by Kucherov with 32 to go. Now Hedman lays it carefully along to Johnson. Got it back across to Stamkos. Stamkos led it to Hedman. Blocked there by Hagelin. Tucked back in, delayed offside.
Make that play if you're Nick Bonino. You had a lot of room to skate, take that ice, and now you give the Lightning a free opportunity to face off to the left of Matt Murray. There's Carl Hagelin, and there you see Bonino going for the empty net.
They scored on one in game six. What good score there.
About a timeout here from the Penguins.
You would think.
Sure enough.
Bonino came over to the bench. Sorry about that, boys. And you see him get patted on the back.
And in that situation, you're getting communication from the guys on the ice and on the bench, but with the building up for grabs, it is really hard to hear. You see Ian Cole yelling at Bonino. And usually the message is time, hurry up, all those type of things. But Bonino goes through the empty net, and the Lightning live to fight another opportunity in the offensive zone with a faceoff to the left of Matt Murray.
Bonino 9 of 16, Johnson 6 out of 20 in faceoffs tonight.
If you're Johnson, you got to go in for a tie-up and get some help with one of those 50-50 pucks that end up under the linesman.
Off the tie-up, it's squibs behind, thrown along by Letang, but it kicked on over for Mata, and it's off the glove of Stamkos. The net is empty, and it will be called back. It will be called back.
The puck hits somebody on the Penguin bench. as that puck was being cleared. So the faceoff will stay inside the zone of the Pittsburgh Penguins. Right part of your screen. Now the question is, did it hit somebody off the Penguins first and then off of Steven Stamkos? Can't tell from there. And you see Steven Stamkos right away pointing in, saying it hit somebody on the Penguin bench. You see guys' arms and sticks hanging over, and I'm not sure if that's what it hit. But before Hagelin put the puck into the net, referee Wes McCauley was skating back the other way. That come off the stick of Ben Lovejoy. Lovejoy's yelling at, yeah, you see the stick move of Lovejoy, so the faceoff should be to the left of Matt Murray inside the Penguin zone. A great pickup by our crew.
And a very alert pickup by the four men that are wearing the stripes tonight.
No question.
Absolutely right.
They only get the one look at it. Otherwise, this is a 3-1 game. They have posted the third goal into the empty net.
They're checking the clock right now with the headset. Not reviewing that play that happened on the ice, but just to see how much time is up on the board.
10.4. Both timeouts have been used. Quickly, Matt Cullen being instructed by his coach, Mike Sullivan. It is Filppula this time against Bonino. Filppula is the better percentage guy for the Lightning in the series. As a matter of fact, he is the best. He is 15 out of 23 in this game tonight, trying to win it away from Nick Bonino, who has been the best of the Penguins, and Bonino prevailed. It's Mata turning behind with seven to go. The battle on for it, it popped up in the air. Still it's kicked along, reaching in is Bonino. 2 seconds to run, the Penguins are wild. Started out the season with disappointing first 2 months. Even a coaching change was necessary in Pittsburgh, and they gallantly waged a 7-game battle here in the conference final. Trevor Daley limited to crutches, but at the bench to celebrate a great night for his team. And now the Penguins peel off from their celebration, and the congratulations and the handshakes begin. You always think of those who have had issues during the course of the series. The captains, the coaches have not had. Chris Letang and Ryan Callahan, they did. It dissolves. Isn't it something? Andrei Vasilevskiy does not know a lot of English, but I think he senses the congratulations he's getting from some of the Penguin shooters. They got some past him, but not nearly as many as they tried and they wanted. Only 21.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand by for the official presentation of the Prince of Wales Trophy to the Eastern Conference Championship.
communicates pretty well. Do they both? Coach is very well spoken. Great guys to deal with. And Mike Sullivan will move on. And John Cooper will have a word with Matt Murray.